here called Lester. This year she won double. At the same time, I tell you, if God has blessed you last year before, you have not seen any blessing. This year, double.
Amen.
Multiple.
Amen.
Will be your portion.
Amen.
Look at Deuteronomy 28 in verse 1. And it shall come to pass, it will come to pass in your life. If, that word if means command inside. If thou shalt act diligently. You see, when you read the Bible, look at every word that is being used. He says, shall come to pass. The things I have told you that will happen, they will definitely come to pass. He says, but there is if. In other words, there are conditions you must fulfill, you must meet. If thou shalt act it, not anyhow, but how diligently. You know how to be diligent? In other words, you look at what are the things in my life. God wants me to obey Him. What area? In which area? You look at your life. You look at the Bible. And there are some areas in my life that I am not meeting up with God's word. Diligently. If thou acting, diligent unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe and do how many of His commandments? Some people say, of God, 99% is zero. You see how? James said, out of the 10 commandments, if you obey 9 and you disobey in 1, you are disobeying in all. He said, if thou shalt act to observe and do all His commandments which I command thee this day, that the Lord thy God will set you on high above all nations of the earth.
Amen.
This year you are going to be lifted.
Amen.
I say you are going to be lifted.
Amen.
If you have been living in one corner, they will notice you this year.
Amen.
I say they will notice you this year.
Amen.
Even as a church, this year, the Lord will announce the church.
Amen.
And all these blessings shall come on thee. They will come on thee.
Amen.
And overtake thee.
Amen.
Then he said, if thou shalt act unto the word of the Lord thy God. When God is repeating something, don't take it lightly. He said, blessings will overtake you, Paul. There must be something. Verse 3. Blessed shall thou be in the city. You are going to be blessed. Blessed shall thou be in the field. Blessed shall be the fruit of thy body. And the fruit of thy ground. And the fruit of thy cattle, the increase of thy kind, the flock of thy sheep. Verse 5. Blessed shall be thy basket and thy store. Blessed shall thou be when thou comest in. And blessed shall thou be when thou goest out. The Lord shall call thy enemy that rise against thee to be smitten before thy face.
Amen.
They shall come against thee one way and flee before thee several ways.
Amen.
The Lord shall command the blessings upon thee in thy storehouses.
Amen.
And in all that thou settest thy hand unto. Every business you lead, you plan, you do this year, the Lord said it will be blessed. He shall bless thee in the land which the Lord has given thee. God will give somebody land this year. God will give the church land this year. Yesterday I was praying. The Lord opened my eyes. And we just built the church building. And the women were busy cleaning. So the outside was still rough. So as I want to enter, so that what they are doing will not be stained. So I was working and punching my head, so dusting my head to enter. You say, don't ask me how. Because the God I serve, for with him nothing shall work impossible. Very soon you are going to see what you do. That same yesterday, right? After we closed, after we crossed over, the Lord started speaking to me. And the Lord met me and said, what do you want me? What do you want me to do for you this year? I said, God, I didn't even know anything about it. I prayed the same prayer that Solomon prayed. I said, God, I want wisdom to lead this multitude of people you are giving me. You know, people have been saying revelations about multitude in their church. In other words, in time and spot. And I prayed, and God has given me the wisdom. You are going to see it now. So, the Bible says, the Lord shall call thy enemy that rise against thee from his spirit. Verse 9. The Lord shall establish thee and holy people unto himself. Your business will be established. Your job will be established. Your marriage will be established. The church will be established. Then he said, and you all that have said it, the hand on to verse 9, brother. As your sword is thou, and he repeated it again, he thou shalt keep the commandments, not just one commandment, the commandments of the Lord thy God, and walk in his way. Don't walk in your own way. Don't walk in the ways of Satan. Don't walk in the ways of the world. Verse 10, and all people of the earth shall see. Amen. Is what God is going to do in this church is not going to be easy. And what God is going to do in your life is not going to be easy. People will see it. And all people of the earth shall see that thou art called by the name of the Lord. And they shall be afraid of thee. I say they shall be afraid of thee. Instead of you being afraid of the enemy, the enemy will walk, be afraid of thee. Amen. Verse 11. The Lord shall make thee plenteous in goods. In the fruit of thy body, in the fruit of thy cattle, in the fruit of thy ground, in the land which the Lord swore unto thy fathers to give thee. The Lord shall open unto thee his good treasure. The heaven to give the rain unto thy land in its season. And to bless how many? All the work of thy hand. And thou shalt lend unto many nations. And thou shalt not borrow. This year you are not with the world. Rather, you are living the one to be lending. People say, I beg anything for me. You say, when are you going to pay? Is that pay so far? And if you are owing before the end of this year, mark the word and see. Before the word will not fall to the ground. Before the end of this year, that debt is cancelled. The Bible says, verse 13, the Lord shall make thee the head. The Lord shall make thee the head and not the tail. Thou shalt be above all and thou shalt not be beneath. If thou art king unto the commandment of the Lord thy God, which I command thee this day to do them. You see, God cannot lie. When God says, I will, he will. But I will not deceive you. The blessing of God. For you to receive the blessing, you have a part to play. The part he expects of you is obedience. I'm going to look at this message from three areas. Number one, even if we can't pray today, we must hear the word. This is like the syllabus for the year. And we must get it complete and correct. Because it's not enough to pray, and we are not seeing results. First, we want to look at complete scriptural obedience. What? When we say scriptural obedience, what does it mean? Under this, I will look at telling the two areas, rather than one measure of scriptural obedience. In other words, what and what area are you supposed to obey God? Number one, Bible says, let the wicked forsake his way, and your righteous man is tall, and let him return unto me. That is in Isaiah 55 verse 7. So number one, you must obey God by repenting of your sin. Surrender your life together. Isaiah 1:18 says, come now, let us reason together. Though your sins be as scarlet, they shall what? Be white as snow. And the Bible says in Proverbs 28:13, he that covereth his sin shall not prosper. So please, mark it. Bible says if you cover your sins, you hide your sins, you shall not what? Prosper. But whoso confesseth and forsake them will what? Will get what? Have mercy. The Lord will have mercy. So you must obey God in the area of repentance if you have not repented of your sin. Number two, you must obey God in making your way the right with man. For instance, there's something that don't belong to you. Maybe you are walking somewhere, as maybe as a boy learning walk, or as somebody helping somebody, and you took something, and that thing was not given to you. And then the young guy came and said, who took this thing? He said, I didn't know. You need to go and return that thing. That was called restitution. You know, Zacchaeus meant the Lord. Jesus Christ said, I'm coming to your house. And Zacchaeus knows that Jesus Christ is high there. They are sharper than the eyes of eagles. And I know that you will see everything. So before Jesus comes, he said, Lord, please, from this day, if I take anything from any man, I'm going to restore you fourfold. Clear your account. Don't hide anything from God. Open up to God. Then if you have wronged somebody, you told lie against somebody, and because of that, the person suffered for it. Go and say, please have mercy. Forgive me. This is what I did. You must, Bible say, hear it wise, size myself. To always have a person void of offense towards God and what? Toward man. That is in Acts chapter 24, verse 16. Some people say, the conference is telling you this thing, God. They say, keep quiet. No, you cannot be blessed that way. There must also be separation from the world. I will say, come out from among them and be what? Separate. 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 17. Come out. I will say, what conquer? And Christ with Balaam. What communion are he that believeth with an unbeliever? And then, the way the world is very offensive to God. The world is offensive to God. The Bible says in James 4:4, friendship with the world is what? Enmity with God. Then, 1 John chapter 2, 15 to 17 says, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man love the world, what happens? The love of the Father is not in him. For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the heart, and the pride of life is not of the Father, but what is of the world. And he said, those that love the world will pass away. But he that dwells the will of God abideth forever. Then you must also live a righteous and holy life. Look at 1 Peter chapter 1. I read verse 14 to 16. Then I go to 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 11. You see, there are secrets of being blessed by God. I did say that this year is a year of open door, but there are conditions for the doors to remain open. Because if God opened the door and you disobey God, God is not the one that will come and close it. Satan will come and close the door. And when Satan comes to close the door, God's hands will be tied. Satan will say, God, he disobeyed you. You said that if anyone disobeys, I have my soul, I am in my charity. Jesus Christ said, that anybody that for these believers from evil spirits. He said the evil spirit, when they left a man, after some time, will come back to check where they are gone from. If they find that the place is empty, empty of righteousness, empty of the word of God, empty of faith, empty of prayer, they say we'll go and get seven more wicked spirits and come and dwell inside that man. And the Bible says the last day of that man will be worse than the first. So if you want God to keep your door open, you must be holy. Look at 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 14. As obedient children, that's the word. As obedient children, not fashioning yourself according to the former laws in your ignorance. But as he which has called you is holy, so who are, be ye holy in all manner of conversation. Because in this reason, be ye holy, for I am holy. God cannot walk with the unrighteous, and he cannot bless the unrighteous. Because if he does that, then the people of Sodom and Gomorrah will say, God, you are impartial. This one did worse than us. You killed all of us. Because the Bible says in Habakkuk chapter 1, verse 13, God is of purer eye than to behold iniquity. Look at 2 Peter, the 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 11. Dearly beloved, I beseech you, I beg you, as strangers and pilgrims, brethren, know that you are a stranger in this world. You are on a pilgrimage here. One day, your visa in this world will expire. So, you are going to go back. If you don't go back, you will be repatriated. So, and when you go to a strange land, they said that when a fowl get the strange back, now one leg, they stand. Don't stand the two legs on this world and be engulfed by the evil in this world. He said, dearly beloved, I beseech you as sinners and pilgrims, abstain from fleshly love which war against the soul. You know what is called fleshly love? Immorality, adultery, fornication, uncleanness. Bible says they war against the soul. Your soul is precious to God. And when you are continually doing that, you are killing your soul. You must also obey God's word that says, go ye out into the world and do what? Preach the gospel. You must do evangelism this year. Tell people about Christ. You see, when you are doing work for God, God will be blessing you. You cannot be working for Satan, supporting Satan, promoting Satan, and expect God to bless you. No, you are not working like that. If you want God to bless you, be on God's path. Cross over, move from Satan's party to Jesus' party. You see all these PDP APC. If you are a PDP and the government is APC, they will not give you appointments. I mean, if they even mention your name, the other people say, no, we don't have here, nothing like that. There's one of my friends, Abuja. He worked for Bayelsa government before. So after the administration finished, one federal agency ran gave him appointment. People say, no, this man, a PDP man. He was not really a PDP man. He was just offering professional service, like when I was in government. I said, I'm not a politician. I'm not providing any professional service. He was not a party man. But they protested on me. They left the place. The same way, you cannot be working for Satan and expect God to bless you. So if you want God to bless you, leave the camp of Satan. Come to the side of God and then promote the kingdom of God. You know marketers. Eh? They are setting job. You are paid based on what you bring in. That's why those marketers in the bank, they are working. And when somebody employs somebody as a marketer in the bank, I don't envy that person. Because they will give the person target. The person does not meet target before you know, the person is shown the way out. They are looking at what are you bringing in. If you are bringing nothing, then you can't expect the company to be paying you when you are bringing nothing. No profits. So the same way, when you are not bringing souls into the kingdom, you are not preaching the word, either through social media or one-on-one. Now you can also be sending WhatsApp and the rest of people. But who are you here? The child of God never tell a soul about God. And you're saying, God is happy? No way. He said, occupy till I come. The one that went and used talent, the master talent, when he came, he was thrown into after that. He will not be thrown into after that. Then God said, bring all the tithe into my house, that they will meet. It's not because I'm a pastor here. These are things I have practiced in my life. When I was working, I don't play with my tithes. Then, even as a student, I was paying tithe. The money you give me, I paid tithe that profit. As a student. Then, apart from time, I will say upon the first day of every week, let each of you pay by him in store as God has prospered him. Jesus Christ said in Luke 6:38, give and it shall be all given unto you. This principle is not because somebody is pastoring him. God is meeting me at the point of money. God raises him from things I don't even expect. To take care of you, God, the word he gave you was that I will take care of you. And God is taking care of me in different ways. So it's not because I'm the pastor here. This is the Bible. God said, if you don't pay that, your heaven is locked, but your heaven is not locked. Then the second you pay, your heaven is open, he said, I will pour out the word, a blessing that you will know you are rolling on. Then, we are supposed to serve him fervently. We are supposed to abide in his word. And we are supposed to please him. How are we to obey God? We have to obey God promptly. Some people hear the word of God and they deny it. Psalm 119 verse 60 says, I made haste and delayed not to keep thy statute. How does the parent feel? You tell the child, go and bring this thing. You said it once, the child sit put. You repeat it, the child sit put. Then the third time, grudgingly and with grumbling. Oh, my little mother, you don't try that with her. You don't try that with her. If you try it with her, You will curse the day and swear the night you were born. I remember there was one time we were in the fishing camp. They said, we should go to Libra. I said, I'm not going to Libra today. And when you say you are not going, you are looking at her because she will take off like a lion. So you yourself, you are prepared. So before she take off, I took off. I jumped into the river. She entered the volcano. And I started swimming. She got me more and I went under the water. Then you and I, you cannot stay 1 minute under the water. If you like, you are right. He said, I tried to water. I go, sir. Except the diverse and special Africa, people all go to the river. But you and I, don't think we suppose, I can stay what I want to do. If they come, before you do 30 seconds, you are finished. So where I went in, she just stayed there. Then finally I came out and I was tired, just driving inside the boat, the meeting that day, and the same lesson you refused, you are going to go out. Then think about God. When God said, do this thing, don't delay. Delay obedience is disobedience. Then also, you obey it completely. Not that you are doing some alien, some other thing that says, oh God, don't go there. No, God will not take part from any human being. That text we read says, if thou shalt do, for you know, all, not some, not few, say all. Saul, that was not Saul. He said, we are feeling the people. And you brought their things. Then they are animals. You brought them. And Saul said, what are you doing? He said, oh, we brought them to sacrifice to God. You think God, your sacrifice, but don't take sacrifice. He said, to be in better than sacrifice. He lost the flow because of that. And we have obeyed God always. After all, I've been obeying God since now. This one, God may understand. That language is from kingdom of darkness. There's nothing like God understands. Jesus said in John 8:29, he that sent me is with me. The Father has not left me alone, for I do always those things that are pleasing. If Jesus is doing always the things that are pleasing God, then you and I, you have the excuse to be made partial with God. Those who are obstinate, that brings your second point, consequence of selfish obstinacy. Those who are disobedient, God is angry with them. The Bible says God is angry with the wicked every day. They will be rejected like Saul. Then they will be destitute of God's presence, God's protection. When Adam and Eve disobeyed God, what happened? He drove them out of the garden, from his presence. And put an end to them, so if they come near, teach them a lesson. Those who disobey God, they are under a curse, affliction. Look at that, the Deuteronomy. Let's read it. Let's read some verses. Deuteronomy chapter 28, now we read. We stop at verse 13. Let's read from verse 14. Just a few verses. The consequence of disobedience. Deuteronomy 28, verse 14. And thou shalt not go aside from any man that walk, from any of the world which I command thee this day, to the right hand or to the left, to go after God to serve them, but it shall come to pass. If thou be not acting unto the voice of the Lord thy God to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come not on you, on those people. Cause. Those who disobey God, they will experience God. They are prayers will not be answered. The Bible says in Proverbs 28, verse 9. He said, he that torment his ears from hearing the law, even his prayer is an abomination. In other words, if you are committing sin, you are disobeying God, you come and pray, it's God. Your praying itself will make God be angry with you. Then, those people, they will wonder about, they will face oppression, captivity, and defeat. When the children of Israel went to Jericho, they didn't fight. They just shouted, praise the Lord, blew trumpet, walked around the city and the wall collapsed. But God said, when you enter the city, don't take anything from them. You see, when God at times gives us instruction, it may not make sense to you. But at times, he knows what he is doing. He said that city is a curse. Because Joshua placed a curse on that city. So if you take anything from it, you are inheriting the curse. That's why Joshua told God said, you are taking of their curse thing. Curse have a place on the city. So because of that, don't take anything. Then Achan said, I'm waiting. Because you know they walk again. Some people say, you know they walk again. What happened? They went to the battle. They started killing the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, on the 36 of them that they came back to God and said, God, what does it matter? Why? You can't protect us. God said, get up from that ground. I will not hear your prayer. There's evil in the ground. There's sin. There's an accosting. My brethren have left you. Get that man that disobeyed me and let him be cut off. It was thereafter they now made and the presence of God went with them. So we lose the presence of God and we suffer defeat in the battle against the kingdom of God. But then, it's better you don't say every power, every mighty power. It's better if you know that you are not listening. Don't just mention them because they are also firing bullets. And if there is loophole, the bullet will enter. Because God will not cover the loophole. Praise the Lord. We are spiritual people. God will not cover. He is of pure eye. He does not do it. He will not cover the loophole. So instead of you firing at them, it's on your own will, you need to be backfired into the Lord. The Spirit of God will not be directing it. So instead of that, they will be doing at least two, and then the bullet will be coming back. Not you, but the person will be disobedient. And then on the last day, Lord will say, I never knew. But that is not your portion. That brings me to the last point. Conversation in sins obedience. When you obey God, as Deuteronomy will say, you are going to be blessed. What are the blessings? Number one, your prayers will be answered. This year, the Lord will hear your prayer. Isaiah 65, verse 24, says, before they call, I will hear. I will answer. While they are yet speaking, I will hear. Then let us read 1 John chapter 3, verse 22. 1 John chapter 3, in verse 22. 1 John 3, 22. 1 John chapter 3, in verse 22. And whatsoever we ask, we receive of him, because we keep his commandments and do those things that are pleasing in his sight. The Bible says, when you are keeping the commandment of God and do those things that are pleasing in the sight of God, that God will answer your prayer. God will answer your prayer. Those who are walking in obedience, righteousness, they will experience the presence and the power of God. Jesus said in that John 8:39, He that sent me is with me. The Father has not left me alone, because I do always those things that pleases Him. And the Bible says in Acts chapter 5, verse 32, that God gives the Holy Ghost to them that obey Him. Some people have been praying for Holy Ghost baptism, but don't be a new baptism. Check your life. He said, I will be. Then those who are obedient to God, their spiritual ears are open. Their spiritual eyes are open. Bible says God does nothing but he immediately to his servants, the prophets. A child of God is not supposed to be living in darkness. God, the Bible says, pour out my spirit of an offense, your young flesh has seen vision. Your old man will dream dream. And then the young man, your servant, your children will prophesy. God's plan for you is that you will be sensitive of your spiritual environment. Those who obey God, they will enjoy the favor of the Lord. And they will experience breakthrough, promotion, prosperity, success, victory, deliverance. They will be fruitful. They will be saved. They will have long life. With long life, will life satisfy Him and show Him my salvation. And on the last day, God will say, come in. Let's go to our text. It's a prophetic declaration I'm making now. So as you read, hear me reading, you say amen. Amen. And if you will else, in the name of Jesus. Deuteronomy 28. Deuteronomy 28. We have our prayer, but let's go back to our text. Deuteronomy 28. I read verse 1. It shall come to pass that hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God to observe and to do all his commandments which I command thee this day, that the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations of the earth. The Lord will set you on high.
Amen.
The Lord will set your family on high.
Amen.
This year, there won't be any limitation in your life.
Amen.
All these blessings shall come on thee and overtake thee.
Amen.
Verse 3. Blessed shall thou be in the city.
Amen.
Blessed shall thou be in the field.
Amen.
Blessed shall be the fruit of thy body,
amen,
the fruit of thy crown, and blessed shall be thy basket and thy store.
Amen.
Blessed shall thou be when thou comest in, and blessed shall thou be when thou goest out.
Amen.
Lord shall cause thine enemy that rise against thee to be smitten before thy face. They shall come against thee one way and flee before thee several ways.
Amen.
Thou shalt command the blessings upon thee in thy storehouse.
Amen.
He shall bless thee in the land with the Lord thy God giveth thee. The Lord shall establish thee and hold thee before unto himself.
Amen.
And all people of the earth shall see that thou art called by the name of the Lord.
Amen.
And they shall be afraid of thee.
Amen.
The Lord shall make thee plenteous in goods, in the fruit of thy body, in the fruit of thy cattle, and in the fruit of thy ground, in the land which the Lord swore unto thy fathers to give thee. The Lord shall open unto thee his good treasure, the heaven to give the rain into thy land in its season, and to bless all the work of thy hand. All the work of your hand are blessed.
Amen.
And thou shalt lend unto many nations.
Amen.
And thou shalt not borrow.
Amen.
And the Lord shall make thee the head and not the tail. And thou shalt be above only, and thou shalt not be beneath. Rise up and let's go to the Lord in prayer. This is the word of the Lord. But you need to look at yourself and you obedient to the Lord. Let's first of all address the issue of obedience. I want you to see.